The HondaJet and Phenom 100 are two of the most technologically advanced light jets on the market. The Phenom 100 is consistently one of the best-selling business jets in the world. And while not as established yet, the HondaJet is one of the most often researched. Today, their upgraded successors, the HondaJet Elite and Phenom 100 EV, have taken over as the standard for each aircraft. We'll get into some of the differences in a few minutes, but Jake, buyers in this market seem to be interested in efficiencies of time and money. Can you break down the typical cost for us?
Yeah, sure. So let's take the baseline, right, of 100,000 miles flown in a year. For both planes, that's about 215 hours flown in 1 year for 100,000 miles. In the HondaJet, on average, you're getting 410 knots. In the Phenom 100, you're getting about the same, maybe a little bit less, 405. So we're splitting hairs at that point. The fuel is interesting. So the fuel for the HondaJet is 123 gallons an hour for a fuel burn. For the Phenom, it's 106. So you're saving almost 20 gallons an hour when you fly. Maintenance reserves, though, you make up for it. Hondas, just like cars, so easy to maintain. So maintenance reserves, this might be the very cheapest one that we do, is $435 an hour for a reserve for a HondaJet. It's $485 for the Phenom 100. So that kind of balances out the fuel burn when we talk about operational costs. Insurance, identical, not a dime difference. Pilot training, pretty much identical. Maybe you'll pay a little bit more for the HondaJet. So yearly DOCs, if you're flying 215 hours a year, for the HondaJet, you're looking at $222,000. For the Phenom 100, you're looking at $218,000. So, right, again, $4,000, we're splitting hairs when you're paying $250,000. And then yearly fixed, again, splitting hairs, $171,000 versus $172,000. So they're just neck and neck as far as operational costs go.
Well, as far as performance specs are concerned, the Honda's improved range over the original model allows it to fly 1,437 nautical miles compared to the Phenom 100 EV's 1,178, giving it a 300 nautical mile advantage. Both aircraft are single pilot rated and carry 5 passengers, so no advantage either way there. If you're an aircraft lavatory critic, however, like me, you'll love the skylight in the HondaJet's fully enclosed lavatory. And honestly, the cabin seems roomier than its competitors, maybe because of the additional natural lighting. Both aircraft have a compelling background. Honda's certainly a household name and has a reported $1.5 billion investment in the creation of the HondaJet. Its unique design with the engines mounted on top of the wings makes it distinctive anywhere. The Phenom was born into a legacy of reliability with roots in Embraer's regional jets and the engineering support that goes along with it. Those that are used to Garmin avionics will find both cockpits familiar, as the Phenom 100 uses Embraer's Prodigy touch flight deck based on the Garmin 3000, and the HondaJet uses the original Garmin 3000.
I will say, before we close this out, that I have been in a HondaJet, and I've been in a ton of Phenoms, and the HondaJet, when they're well-maintained, I mean, they're just so impressive. They just look great.
Visit wepush10.com/resources to learn more about current market values and find even more valuable resources for buying or selling an aircraft.